Hey there, everybody. Kohopika here. Welcome back to more Super Mario Odyssey. In the last very long-awaited episode, we managed to complete the main game of Super Mario Odyssey and defeat Bowser. But then we got our reward here, which is essentially the exploration of the entire Mushroom Kingdom. This can basically be hinted at if you end up essentially going through the Luncheon Kingdom and, you know, the whole surprise is pretty much shot in the foot. But I didn't really decide to do that because, let's be real here, it's kind of a little bit more exciting when you find out that, oh, you can actually explore the Mushroom Kingdom once you've, you know, eventually beaten the game. And it's a really nice bonus for you to get. It's not one of the most exciting bonuses because you only get just one area to explore. It would be kind of nice if you end up, like, exploring, like, other areas, like, say Sunshine or any of those other Mario areas from Galaxy and whatnot. It'd be kind of cool, but I know the reason as to why they didn't really bother to go with the whole stretch of it anyways. But let's actually head into the Mushroom Kingdom, or I should say the Mushroom Kingdom's castle, to see what it actually has in store. It might end up having something of a little bit of a nostalgia soundtrack for those who are familiar with Super Mario 64. Goodbye, Toad. That's right. The song that you are now currently hearing is literally the Super Mario 64 Peach's Castle theme. What's also interesting about this is that this is a literal, almost one-to-one design of Peach's Castle from Super Mario 64. The only difference is that obviously the stairs are a little bit more higher and the doors are missing for each and every single level. But there is something that does end up making a bit of a reference to that with the whole, you know, thing like that. But if you actually look up in the sky, a la Super Mario 64, you actually get yourself not a moon, but a star. And it gives you the same traditional Super Mario 64 sound effect whenever you collect a star. And it's also super interesting about that because the moon also has the same sound effect just like collecting a star. It's basically just da-da-da-da. It's like, what was it again? I actually freaking forgot. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, essentially that version. The only difference is that it just doesn't have a completed tune for it. So there are 100 coins, just like in typical Super Mario 64 fashion, or in any of the Super Mario games, 3D games, where you have to collect 100 of something. There's also a Tanuki tree here, which can go in and say, hey, this game is connected to Super Mario 3D Land for the 3DS. Never actually played 3D Land. It didn't really take my interest. Like, I played 3D World, though. I mean, that was actually pretty interesting, even though 3D World was kind of more so being a carbon copy of 2 instead of, you know, actual 3D, or I should say actual 3 for the most part. So anyways, our major goal here, you notice that our moons are now in a different multicolored moon instead of the traditional whatever color moon it is essentially telling you now we are at literal post-game here, ladies and gents, as I end up literally falling to my death. You know, in old Super Mario 64 fashion, there was never a pit down there. This is a terrible representation of Super Mario 64, I have to say. But before I forget, we need to get onto the roof. Because here, you can kind of end up seeing what these are. Let's talk to this Toad right here. He probably end up explaining what these are.
This is Yoshi's favorite food. I saw him in the castle a while ago. Wonder where he is now.
I don't know why I gave the Toads that voice. You know what? I don't feel like giving them the voice scratching noises. Because you want to know why? I can't do it. I don't feel like killing my voice. It's kind of bad already as is. And also, I just ate before doing this recording. So that's probably probably a bad take on that, but whatever, you're gonna do. Let us see here, what is on this path right here? Ah, golden Goombas. You guys do not exist in traditional Mario fashion. You guys are kind of scary. This one's pretty interesting. This wants you to... This essentially ends up activating this. And you kind of need this to be able to actually go on top of the roof. You probably can get on there with a good little cappy jump dive. But if you are familiar with the 100% of getting all the stars in Super Mario 64 and getting the glorified bomb cannon to shoot you up top of the roof, you will know that someone is always on the roof. And it is Yoshi, but not three one-ups. Mainly because of the fact that... Mario Odyssey does not have lives. It'd be kind of interesting if it did, but it does not. It would be cool, but it just does not. And it's really, really disappointing. Alright. Let's actually get up on top of here, because there is a moon that we can get up here. Or I should say a star. Stars, moons, they're all the same in the end. Okay, maybe there's nothing up here. Maybe a lad. Maybe it's just coins. Well, I mean, coins are pretty much nice, you know? Alright, anyways, let's go ahead and wake up Yoshi, shall we? And now we get, and unlike, you know, traditional, you can go ahead and just, like, you know, jump on Yoshi all willy-nilly. You actually capture him. And now Yoshi's part of you. You are now Yoshi. It's kind of weird. He can actually stick to walls and also does his flutter jump and also reuse the same sound clip just, like, from Super Mario Sunshine. I swear, that sound effect is literally from Super Mario Sunshine. I think. Or, you know, Super Mario Galaxy as well, because it's the same Yoshi reused clips. And, unfortunately, this Yoshi is a Sunshine Yoshi, because if he goes in water, he dies. Nintendo, we haven't learned our lesson from Sunshine, have we? I mean, hey, you guys are essentially making every single reference that you can at this point. So, hey, if you want to make a reference to Sunshine Yoshi, by all means, it's great, but no one liked that Yoshi. I mean, mind you, I didn't really find that very bad, but, you know, it's whatever. All right, so for this section here, you want to go ahead and get rid of all these little stumps to be able to suck up the water. I want to say this is a reference to Super Mario 64's basement area, where if you end up ground pounding on the two pillars, it ends up draining the water. I like to think that it is, because those are the only time where you can actually drain the moat from Peach's castle. It's kind of weird. It makes no sense as to why it was the only place, and it probably ends up giving the justification as to why Bowser was able to infiltrate Peach's castle. And it also gives you the confirmation sound effect from Super Mario 64 as well. I'm probably going to mute myself and also just make sure you hear the sound effects that the game ends up making. It's great. All right. So we need to get Yoshi back, but you know what? I'm just going to leave Yoshi alone because he's fine. But I want to introduce something before we kind of continue on further into the Mushroomy Kingdom. You get to refight bosses again. But there are in portraits, and, you know, just like in a la portraits, you can jump into them. But, I keep saying but a lot. Anyways, the point is, hear the sound effect when you jump into said painting. I wish he said, let's-a go, but he does not, which is really a shame, and they should have added the let's-a go just to cap off the nostalgic factor. And you know, most people say that, oh, let's be real, Super Mario hasn't really done a little bit of a nostalgic thing unless you're talking about the 3D games, which kind of does a lot of that. Like, I know 3D Land does the nostalgia bit here, but it's kind of like unfortunate, you know? So, for this fight, it's a lot, for all the refights of all the bosses, there is a little bit of a difference that ends up happening with each and every single fight. As you can see here, with little Total Man, he ends up essentially having the capabilities of these wonderful zombies. So the zombies essentially are helping him out this time. And I don't think you can have any hearts to spawn. So I just basically just died there. So that was great. I mean, you know, it's fine. Sometimes, you know, you just gotta die. And you literally get kicked out, just like in Super Mario 64 as well. After doing the fight without actually talking, I managed to kick the dudes behind. Sometimes talking and fighting is not really my forte in commentary, which is really bad. But then again, it's been a while since I actually played this game, so I'm gonna make that as an excuse. Anyways, multi-moon get! Oh, yeah. All right, cool. Now that I finally have no recollection of to how that fight actually went, excited was full-on concentration. But it doesn't really matter. And, you know, if I was actually good at editing, I would literally put in the da-da-da-da-da-da. And it's like, yeah, I defeated him because I beat him. And that's me. And yeah, and I'm Mario. All right, so to make the bit, this area to be a little bit more fitting rather than whatever this is right now, we're a little bit too modern. I don't like being modern. Let's go classic, shall we? Let's go a little bit classic. Let's get some classic in there. Yeah, let's get some classic. Yo, what's up, my toads? Give me a star, please. Why are you having... Oh, yeah, I forgot. You can now bend up buying essentially 10 stars or whatever from toads now. You're probably wondering, what's the point of actually doing that? Well, there are two reasons. One, it's so that you can be able to gain access to the final area of the game. But the thing is that it won't count towards the main total of 999. I'm not going after all the moons because that will be really redonkulous, let's just say. So anyways, here you can now end up buying newer costumes. You can buy a Luigi outfit, so to make the whole L is real thing, actual thing now, because at the time of this recording, and trust me, it's been a very long time, the whole leaks end up basically data mining the fact, well, not really data mining, end up finding out that Luigi actually was in Super Mario 64, so L is indeed real, but not Waluigi done. Waluigi would never be in Smash, guys, just leave it alone. You have the Doctor's outfit, you have the Waluigi outfit, you have the Diddy Kong outfit. I don't know why it's Diddy Kong and not Donkey Kong, but then again, Donkey Kong doesn't wear a hat. Diddy Kong does, so that's probably the reason. You have the employee still outfit. You have the boxer shorts. You have the musician outfit. You have the sunshine outfit, which was added into the DLC. Well, one of the updates. Same goes for the knight helmet, which was also in an update. The you can actually tell which one was an up, which ones are updates and which ones are not updates. I think the ones that has like the special symbols are the ones that are updates, and the ones that do not have the special symbols are, yeah, because you can see here is like these are essentially all the updates for the you being able to wear the bosses, you being able to wear a Halloween zombie outfit, a Santa outfit, and you know, 8-bit Mario cap, which is like a lot. Jesus, that's a bit much. I'm gonna be personally honest with you. Trying to go after all of those is a bit of a pain because the grinding method is still using the vines, but you can also use Balloon Luigi, which is a new feature that they obviously added into the mix to be able to make money grinding special. But now we're in the Super Mario 64 Mario, except the only difference is that the controls don't suck. Anyways, let's talk to Luigi, because I don't think I showcased this during the LP. Hey, I have seen that outfit but somewhere. Anyway, looking good, bro. Hey, bro, you saved Princess Peach, huh? So proud of you. But enough of that. Get this, bro. I came up with a new game. I call it Balloon World. Balloon World is a game where you search for balloons hidden by people all over the world. Oh, you should know that if you play your high score, your nickname and profile icon will show up on the other people's games. You want to connect to the network? Yeah, sure, why not? I mean, I got an internet connection. Unless it actually doesn't work on this. Yeah, I kind of figured. Anyways, I guess we cannot show Balloon Luigi unless, you know, I end up going into my other main file to be able to showcase that. I guess I could probably do that at some point. I won't do it now because we're kind of in the middle of a stride right now. But I am going to stop here, though. I kind of will end up showing Luigi's Balloon game at some point, but the main goal for right now is to technically just get to the end of the final stretch of the game, to be honest, because that's really all we're going to do. So I've been CodePeekin, and I'll be seeing you guys in the next episode of Super Mario Odyssey. Laters!